If you use Redbubble or TeePublic or any of the print-on-demand websites to design t-shirt stickers or any kind of apparel, then you probably spend a lot of time on your actual primary design. So I have a few tips here on how you can get more bang for your buck, or more specifically, more designs based out of your primary design. So here I'm using Redbubble as an example, but this could apply to other POD websites as well. So here I just uploaded a royalty-free image of a deer on Redbubble. So I'm just using it for this example. So imagine that this is your design. So notice just under the deer, there's a primary color. In this case, it's pure white. And that color is going to apply to every item that we customize and we activate. Sites like Redbubble and TeePublic have a lot of different apparel and things like stickers and bath mats and so on. But it's really all coming back to your one primary design. So in this case, it's a deer. So my first tip, tiling your design. Here I've clicked on graphic t-shirts, and now I can customize that specific product. So on the bottom right, there's a repeat option. Now I call it tiling, but it basically repeats the design in a pattern. So here's the important part. There's two tiling options. The first option tiles your design in a grid. So see all the little deer? They're perfectly aligned, both vertically and horizontally. The other option tiles your design in an offset grid. So in this case, the deer are slightly offset. It reminds me of like a brick wall, for example. So you can set up your design with one repeat option, save it and publish it, and then go back and do it again, but switch up the tiling option and use the other one. So it's a small switch, but it may be the difference between someone not buying your design or someone pulling the pin and purchasing it. Tip two is using color in your designs. When you first upload your design, the default color is white. And we can see it there where the arrow is pointing. Now this does not apply to t-shirts. They have their own colors. But for most of the other options, like some apparel, shower curtains, bath mats, etc., you can pick the actual background color. So in this example, I've published my original deer with a white background. So I'm done. Then I go back in a second time and I disable the t-shirts because the design's the same. But I change the background color on the other designs and I activate those. So here we can see the different designs with a pink background, which is my new default background. So floor pillows are a great example. You can do a white pillow, which is very popular, and then you can go back a second time and you can have the same primary design but with a different background color, like pink here for example. Tip number three is inverting your primary design. So after I published my deer with a white background and then my deer with a pink background, I took my original deer design and in Photoshop, I just inverted the image. So this gives you a similar image, but it's a different color palette. Now in this case, on Redbubble, I also changed the default background color to black. Now when I look at my apparel options, I have a completely different look. So the only change I made to the primary design was to go into Photoshop and invert it. And you can Google how to invert a picture in Photoshop. It's pretty easy. This is really helpful if you have a text design and if you have white text, and then you can redo it and do black text. So you basically get two for one. I really hope you enjoyed this short video, and I'm going to be making lots more here on Redbubble, TeePublic, and other passive income. So if you like what you saw today, consider subscribing. Thanks a lot for watching.